Okay, we are back again. excuse me. Whew! I'm trying to think now. When was the last time that we did a Drezen Draws? Let me see. Not that long ago. December 15th, 2022. That was the last Drezen Draws. Before that, the last one you could vote on. Over a year. So, I want to start by thanking everyone that voted for the candidates. We ended up with a tie, and we're actually going to get into that in just a second. Unless somebody voted at the last minute, in which case, I hate you. I mean, yeah, it's good to be back. Quite honestly, Oh, that's interesting. Let me see something. That's odd. That's a little bizarre. Okay, anyways, there's three of you here. There's three of you here. I can't speak today. I apologize. There's an emergency vehicle outside somewhere, but nobody cares about that, except for the person having an emergency, which I hope they're okay. So anyways, I'm Rich Drezen. This is Drezen Draws. This is my studio here in a place in a building that's on land, which you will not know. And if you show up at my house, I might throw a pie at you. Because, well, you know. Anyways, this right here is where we're going to draw. This is a Wacom Cintiq 22 HD. I have had it for quite some time. I want to thank Ian, whose last name escapes me at the moment. But Ian got this thing working again. When it just kind of died. So, thank you, Ian. I apologize, I can't remember your name at the moment, but I will in a future episode. It's been such a while since I've done this. I am a little nervous, but, you know, I think we'll get through it. And if you like what you see here, you can commission me for birthday parties, corporate events, any kind of special events. If you're having a coming out party, if you're having a divorce party, I will do your divorce party. Anything that you want to celebrate and you want to hire someone to do caricatures, or if you're a bit of a masochist and you want someone to draw really silly pictures of you in a bunny suit, I'm your person. Hit me up. Let's see, what else do I have in the slideshow? I am open for commissions. I'm always open for commissions. Commissions start at $50 each. You can add a character for $35 each. All depends on complexity, of course. I also do pet portraits. I will draw pretty much anything except for NSFW material. That means not safe for work. If it's not something you can show your mother, chances are you don't want me drawing it. And with that, we had a three-way tie in the votes. So the tie was between, and now I got rid of it, Peter Griffin, Barney the Dinosaur, and the Mike Myers Cat in the Hat. So now what we're going to do, because some of you wanted to make my life difficult and not pick one or the other. Nah, vote for whatever you want. I'm just messing around. Hang on just a second while I try to remember how to do this. What is this FC thing?
Oh.
Okay. That means front camera. So I'm going to go to the side camera. I'm going to dismount this, and hopefully I'll be able to remount it and not knock over anything else that's on my desk. So here comes the tiebreaker. What are we doing? You know, it's funny. I'm not even gonna start rambling. I'm just gonna start the music, and I'll ramble as I draw. Okay. Let me see how the audio compares real quick to what I'm seeing in the levels. Okay. Okay. All right, so first up, we are going to draw everyone's favorite ogre, Shrek. And we are in the wrong file. Let's get into the right file. I draw in Adobe Illustrator. I have a second monitor over here that... Get out of here, PETA. I'm going to be looking over my shoulder the whole time. Maybe I shouldn't do that. Oh, well. Not the worst thing in the world. If you like what you see here, and you want to commission me for stuff, I highly recommend that you do that. Because I enjoy having fun and drawing stuff for other people and meeting new people and eating cheese doodles and petting cats and all that fun stuff. Cats are cool. Everybody loves cats. If you could also share this video with your friends, I've never drawn Shrek before. This is a first. And you might be wondering why, if you don't like these characters, would you dedicate a live stream drawing characters you don't like? Isn't that hate watching? I mean, listen, I'm a professional. I've heard about this controversy with a little show called Velma. I haven't seen Velma. I don't really plan to. You know, I don't really make a lot of time to watch a lot of new shows. Because, quite honestly, I'm very busy. I freelance for a movie studio you may have heard of called Trauma Entertainment. and they are wonderful people. I enjoy freelancing for them. They are very far away from my doorstep, but Michael Herz and Lloyd Kaufman are delightful people, as is Maris Herz, who's Michael's wife, as is Garrett Sullivan, Lloyd's assistant, and Kyle Corwin, the staff editor at Troma. I feel very fortunate to be in a position of graphic designer, freelancing for them, because before that I was working in a place that, while one of the higher-ups valued me, nobody else did. So it's a nice change of pace, and this is actually going along a lot better than I expected. Now, I forced myself to do an episode with characters that not only do I not draw regularly enough, but characters that I don't particularly care for. To prove that I am a professional and I will draw just about anything, I don't really care what it is, I don't care if I'm a fan or not, I'm just, like, whatever. The computer is new, the tablet is not. I think maybe I'll scrap the ears and get back to those. I don't know, maybe I should stop myself from going into what I was planning on going into. But anyways, and no, like I said, I don't do NSFW. This is a family show. Occasionally I have some fun, and I have characters doing very silly things. What am I gonna have you doing? Oh, wait a minute. Donkey! Yeah, sorry, John, I didn't see your comments until just now, because... Silly Facebook. I think I know what I'm going to do.
This ain't just Whistling Dixie. It's not cricket either.
I don't know if he has three fingers, four, whatever. I don't understand why a lot of cartoon characters have four fingers instead of five. That's something long before my time. My good friend Tommy Jose Staffis could probably answer that. You know, I'll put the ears back as they were. Maybe in the right place. Thank you.
You know, I just realized I probably should have.
You know, I'm gonna change the poll. I really shouldn't do this. Okay. All right. There we go. But Shrek is one of the wieners. Yeah, there we go. So if any of you want to finish that song, want to finish that lyric, by all means, go ahead. You're welcome to it. Had won, it might have been totally appropriate because I'm playing jazz music in the background, courtesy of Epidemic Sounds, so now I'm obligated to say it.
You like jazz?
Yeah. Honestly, I'm not one to just go off on a rampage about things I don't like, but B-movie is honestly one of the worst movies I've ever seen. It's so terrible. I don't know why it became a meme, but then again, nobody knows how a meme becomes a meme. It just is. It's fine, it's whatever, you know, some people get their jollies out of it. And I just draw cartoons and try to make a living like the rest of the world. Even though some people would not count me in with the rest of the world, and that's okay. That's totally fine. I don't want to be part of the rest of the world anyway. I just want to stay home all day and draw cartoons. Drawing cartoons is fun. Shrek is one of the winners. I love you, John. See if I can maybe condense this down so that anatomy is very important, because without it, you don't get better as an artist. I mean, you might in your own little way. it's always good to experiment and learn and grow and do cool stuff. Things, because things are fun and stuff. I like fun things. And also, using reference material is very strongly suggested. If you have original characters, I recommend that you do the same thing. Because I found, for the longest time, I was struggling to get characters to look consistent. It's a lot of hard work to do that. So, one way that you can try to make it a little easier on yourself is by making model sheets or by getting model sheets. If we're talking like characters that you did not create, or in some cases don't have the rights to. Now, a word about that. Practice is fine. When you start making prints, it's a little different. I say, ask permission. I don't sell Drezen Draws prints anymore. I don't plan to. And it's okay. No. I have my own original art that, my own original projects that I'm working on. Particularly Lucky Zilla. Which, for those of you that are new here, I will, endeavor to explain to you what Lucky Zilla is. First of all, it is my life's work. I cannot get away from it, nor do I want to. In case you're wondering, no, I'm not going to draw a logo on here, on this hat that Trek is holding. Because chances are, it's probably not your team, and also, Trek does not care what everyone likes. I mean, I'm just saying. Can't fault a dude who knows what he wants. When I first saw Shrek, I thought it was very, very, very cool. I couldn't believe how successful Shrek was. I don't think anyone in the film industry could believe how successful Shrek was. My problem is with Shrek 2 and above. Oh, I got 6 viewers. I can't remember the last time I had 6 viewers. So, whoever you are, thanks for joining us. This is the 129th episode of Drezen Draws. For those of you that are new here, I offer commissions starting at $50. Very reasonable. And I also offer birthday parties, corporate events, and individual art instruction. I really should put that in there. Yeah, maybe I will. At some point. I'm just getting back into it with the ads. And also, just, you know, so that I can show my face, this is what I look like. And I got reference material in the background so that I can kind of have Shrek and Donkey egging me on, because why not? Well, that's an interesting point. If I do another Shrek episode, maybe what I'll do is I'll make it a call-in episode, and people can call in and try to sing it in Shrek's voice, at least if the video doesn't get pulled for copyright. I've been told that that can happen. At least on YouTube, which is kind of ridiculous. But I don't know. I don't know anymore. All I know is what I'm doing right here, and graphic design, and a few other things. I don't know all the inner workings of the thing, with the things on it that has other things attached to it, and other things attached to those things, which have things. A lot of things, and a lot more things with a lot more thingamajiggers and jigamathingers, and you get the idea. I'm going into trauma tomorrow. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be long because, well, it's a long ride to there. Also finishing up my taxes. Hopefully I get the money back. That'd be nice. Get the money back and to pay the bills.
So I don't want to be like an onion. Because onions have layers. And layers puts you further in debt. And I just realized doesn't exactly have a double chin. Not that there's anything wrong with having a double chin. I mean, I don't really like it, but it's pretty. And, I'm in trouble.
People complain about the first iteration of Sonic for the Paramount films, and I mean, look at this guy's teeth. Like, seriously, complaining about the teeth on a blue hedgehog? When, meanwhile, this guy's choppers broke a mirror. I mean, what's wrong with you people? Over time, I have honestly liked Shrek less and less. I'm just gonna say it. I think Shrek is a terrible movie. But if you like what you see here and you want me to come to your house for
for your son's birthday or your daughter's birthday and draw pictures of Shrek, I will do it. And I will keep my mouth shut about my opinions. And my pricing is very affordable. Just ask my friends Jamie and Diane. For those of you that are still watching, I am grateful because one of the last times before this that I streamed on Facebook, I had like no viewers and I shared to like 60 something groups. Call it spamming if you want. Honestly, I'm just trying to get seen. That's all I really care about is getting seen. Getting eyes on my work. Maybe someone in the comic groups that I'm in will say, oh yeah, that guy, you know, he does decent inking, so why don't we get him for... Some people are going head over heels about Dick Van Dyke being revealed on The Masked Singer. Uh-oh, spoiler alert, I'm getting canceled. Whatever. Please, spoilers, is that the worst thing to happen nowadays? I mean, there's so many other things going on in the world.
Daniel.
I think this song has lyrics in it. I can't tell because I don't like to wear headphones when I stream because it gets a little distractible. Looks like he's wearing some kind of alligator skin. Alligator skin. I can't speak today. I mean, think about it. Shrek lives in a swamp, right? And who else lives in a swamp? Alligators and crocodiles. Sure enough, I guarantee. just kind of making stuff up as I go along now. Like, whatever seems to fit, that's what's going on the proverbial page. Sometimes I just get in the zone and I don't know what to say. And that's okay too. Response rate. We just have to do it in stages, otherwise Illustrator kind of starts to bug out. And save often. When in doubt about anatomy, look at your feet. Look at your legs. Like, one thing about it, where's the bone? Find the bone. Then just measure out by eye. Okay. You got this. That's the lower part of the leg. It bends. Circle. Line. Line, and there's circles at the end. I'll demonstrate. Line, line, circle, and there's a circle here, a bigger circle, because it's connecting to your butt. And then there's another circle down here, another line, and another line, just connected to another circle, and another circle. And that's how we get to the feet. Simple, isn't it? But consequently, it's only simple because someone else had to figure it out the hard way. So, just keep that in mind. Personally, I think Willy the Giant from Mickey and the Beanstalk is a better character than Shrek. I'm sure many would disagree with me, but that's okay. I really don't care. I'm also not the sharpest tool in the shed. Really even be testing the copyright bots right about now. Oh, no worries. No worries, John. I know you're a busy guy, too. These days, I don't think it's possible for anyone to not be busy. Oh, those dratted corporations always want us working, so that they can make more and more money off of our blood, sweat, and tears. I did not think I was going to be able to do it quite like this. I'm proud of myself. Now, unlike previously, I'm going to save my roughs off to the side so that we can see where we started and where we're going. For a second, I thought my keyboard was yelling at me for pressing it too many times. Oh yeah, that's where we are. Rough. Also, it's not a bad idea to take pictures of yourself, and if you have the luxury of digital, to import those pictures of you into your drawing software of choice. Make your picture layer transparent so you can draw on top of it, and trace the pose that you're in. That will help you learn anatomy a little bit quicker, because you're going to see, oh, I can't go over that, you know, because that isn't quite there. You kind of follow along. Also, I'm trying to think of how to say this in a way where it's still a family show. Study your body. Study your body and how it moves. Look in the mirror and make faces. Ah! Ooh! Ah! Grr! Wah! And eventually, you might hit upon a pose that is worth drawing, even if you have to kick yourself in the face to do it. I've been doing this a long time, and at times, I still don't know what I'm talking about. But let's keep moving on. I don't know what I just pressed. Because now we have to color this sucker. Do is we're going to bring in a color reference. That's a little too light. That's a little too mustard. That's still a little too mustard. going all color critical. Okay, I can live with that. Totally surprised myself with this Shrek drawing. And I still have to do the Cat in the Hat. I mean, I don't have to, but... but I will. I said I would do it. I'm a man of my word.
A donkey, I have an idea for a sport. I knock a ball in a gopher hole. Not with a little straight stick, but a little messed up stick. I whack a ball, it goes in a gopher hole.
Got a brown vest on. You might not. Back to the belt. A generic baseball bat. Because why not? Ian Tompkins! That's who it was. That's a dude that fixed my baby. given him Mets colors. Just a reminder for me to take the wife to a Mets game this year. So we went to one last year, and unfortunately it got rained out. And we was there. Still, it was a nice time out. It's a nice time out at the ballpark. Here we go. And that's green. Would it be funnier if he was using Well, Danielle, now that you mentioned it,
there are such things. Now, what are you doing in my swamp?
There we go. Take a quick break. Some of y'all are making memes that I wouldn't want to touch with a 10-foot pole. I just went looking for a reference for the Mike Myers Cat in the Hat, and I saw something that looked very questionable. And it just kind of made me mad. And yet I'm laughing about it. Because what else am I going to do? It's almost like I'm trying not to be that guy, but then inevitably I am that guy. So, let's review again. I am booking birthday parties, corporate events, etc., etc. I will do private lessons. Reach out to me for more information. I am happy to accommodate schedules and budgets of many, many different types. Yeah. Imagine that. It's Drezen Draws, the Mike Myers edition. So, if you want me to commission your favorite Mike Myers character, yeah. By all means, reach out to me. Just remember, no NSFW. Don't do that. So, anyways, let's see. What are we going to have the Cat in the Hat do? first, let me get a feel for the character. The director of The Cat in the Hat, Bo Welch, was the production designer on Batman Returns. Oh, how the mighty have fallen. I'm such a jerk. This one goes out to Lucky Zilla's editor, Eric Grayson. Yeah, he'll love this. He always does. He always does when I make references to his favorite joke that no one understands why it's a joke. It's like one of those things where you gotta be in the room. But certain incidents, conversations, and other factors just play out that way. Sometimes something is funny for no reason whatsoever, other than the timing is just right. I know, yep. The Seuss estate might not like this. And no, he's not doing what do you think he's gonna do? This makes me very happy. Thank you.
like I want to see this movie again. But at the same time, I like myself. And I'm having a good day, and I don't want to ruin it. Honestly, if I'm going to watch a good bad movie, I'm watching Super Mario Brothers. Thank you.
Cat in the Hat was actually my favorite Dr. Seuss book for a very long time. I mean, the cat's just so iconic and defining of the Seussiverse, as it were. And I mean, when I heard that there was going to be a Cat in the Hat movie, I was just like, oh, that's cool. So I think they hit a home run with the Grinch, and Jim Carrey as the title character, but, you know, the movie really missed the mark and disappointed a lot of people. Amongst the disappointed were Dr. Seuss's widow. Yeah, she was not a fan. I'm definitely siding with Audrey on that. I don't know how many people's childhoods I've ruined in the last 75 minutes. But there's still time to ruin more before I'm through with you. I think that sounds like a challenge. I can definitely up the ante in the disturbing department. But then the only place that this live stream would be fit for would be Trauma Now. This drawing is dedicated to my two cats, Maleficent and Jafar. And, yes, those are their actual names. A certain consistency in the strokes. Bit of time saving goes a very long way. Thank you. Because I'm a jerk.
Thank you.
Miguel Vasquez, is that the dude who did Salad Fingers? I can't remember. There are just certain things I don't keep track of. For all sorts of reasons. Oh my goodness. Oh, I'm gonna move that over. Yeah. He saw his own movie, and this was his reaction. Okay.
So we've come to the end of the episode. I want to thank all of our viewers for tuning in and sharing the video if you have. Hint, hint. If you like what you see here and would like to hire me for any of your art needs, graphic design too, because I do that as well, you can commission me. Character commissions start at $50, blah, 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 blah. For more information, hit me up, give me a call, send me an email, drop by my website, get some ideas. I also do birthday parties, corporate events, and other kinds of fun events. Lots and lots of good stuff. I also draw comic books. Yeah, I draw really cool stuff, such as Lucky Zilla number 32, which came out over your winter break. Why did you not read it? Let me go put this merchandise back before I break it. So, before we go, I just want to leave you with the following things. There is no such thing as I can't draw. If you can write your name, that's drawing. Someone had to figure out what your name looked like at one time or another. And if you can't write your name, you can learn to. You have the capacity to. For some, it's more difficult than others. But the fact that we are all here right now, alive, we have the capacity to do a lot of good, and I suggest we head in that direction. Positivity shall rule the day, but only if we come together. And that is why I proudly say, Black Lives Matter, no one is illegal, trans rights are human rights, be kind, be nice to each other, don't judge each other too harshly, criticize constructively. And just be a good person. Costs you nothing. Yes, at times we do need to call people out on social media. That gets exhausting, but, well, you know, some people can't hire a lawyer. It's tough. But also, you know, there's... I just don't like when people do mean things. It makes me sad. And it sometimes makes me a fat, grumpy cartoonist. So, be nice to each other. And stay drawsome.